Welcome students, today we are going to understand the chapter Religious Synthesis Part 2 in History. In the previous video, we have seen that how Bhakti movement emerged by the Nayanars and the Alavars in South India. The base of the Bhakti movement was strengthened by Ramanuja and was continued by many other saints, such as Sant Ramanand, Sant Kabir, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shankara Deva, Narasimha Mehta, Sant Mirabai, Sant Sena, Sant Rohidas, Sant Surdas, Sant Tulsidas, and Sant Basaveshwar, etc. The teachings of Bhakti movement were love of God, humanity, compassion, mercy, etc. Now, we will continue with some similar sects from different religions. Mahanubhav, Hindu sect in Maharashtra, mainly in Amravati district, started by Chakradhar Swami, propagated a religious movement as well as social movement in which all were accepted, irrespective of their caste, and the traditional ritualistic religion was rejected. Sri Chakradhar Swami told his disciples that the Lord takes avatars in all four yugas. There isn't a time in this world when an avatar is absent. But he told of only five of the innumerable avatars, namely Sri Krishna, Sri Dattatreya Prabhu, Sri Chakrapani, Sri Govinda Prabhu, and Sri Chakradhar Swami himself. Even knowing of one of the avatar and walking on the path lightened by him can lead to ultimate bliss, that is moksha. There were only five because these avatars fell in the Guru Parampara. In this picture you can see Pancha Krishna. All these were called as Pancha Krishna, which have five avatars. The first one is Lord Shri Krishna. Lord Shri Krishna was the Guru of Lord Shri Dattatreya Maharaj. Lord Shri Dattatreya Maharaj was the Guru of Lord Shri Chakrapani Maharaj. Lord Shri Chakrapani Maharaj was Guru of Lord Shri Govinda Prabhu, and then Lord Shri Govinda Prabhu was the Guru of Lord Shri Chakradhar Swami. Shri Krishna was born in Mathura, which is in Uttar Pradesh. Dattatreya Maharaj was born in Britkrishram, Uttarakhand, which is in Himalayas. Shri Chakrapani Maharaj was born in Phaltan district, which is in Satara in Maharashtra. Shri Govinda Prabhu was born in Katsur Ritpur, which is in Maharashtra. Lord Shri Chakradhar Swami was born in Bharuch in Gujarat. So Lord Shri Chakradhar Swami, the founder of Mahanubhav Panth, was born in Gujarat. In the 13th century, Chakradhar Swami founded Mahanubhav Panth in Maharashtra. This sect preaches devotion to Krishna. Shri Govinda Prabhu was the Guru of Chakradhar Swami. The followers of Chakradhar included men and women belonging to all castes and creeds. He supported equality. He traveled to all parts of Maharashtra, preaching in Marathi. He preferred Marathi instead of Sanskrit. This led to the development of the Marathi language. Many works were composed in Marathi. This sect is mainly spread in the Vidarbha and Marathwada regions of Maharashtra. Riddhipur in Vidarbha, you can see here an image which is about the Riddhipur in Vidarbha. It is an important place for people of this sect. This sect had reached up to faraway regions like Punjab and Afghanistan. Some of the main compositions of the followers of Mahanubhav Pant are the treatise Lila Charitra, compiled by Mhim Bhatt, describing the deeds of Chakradhar Swami, Dhavale, of the first Marathi poetess Madamba, Sutrapath and Drishtantapath, compiled by Keshobaz, Vacharan of Damodar Pandit, Shishupalvada of Bhaskar Bhatt Borikar, and Rukmini Swayamvara of Narendra. Guru Nanak was born on 15 April 1469 at Rai Bhoi ki Talwandi village. Here you can see in the image the Rai Bhoi ki Talwandi place. It is present day Nankana Sahib, Punjab in Pakistan, in the Lahore province. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism and the first guru of Sikhs. Nanak is said to have voiced interest in divine subjects. His work has to be mentioned as a great attempt at religious synthesis. He visited the holy places of both Hindus and the Muslims. The basis of Sikhism lies in the teachings of the Guru Nanak and his successors. The successors of Sikhism are Guru Nanak Dev, Guru Angad Dev, Guru Amar Das Sahib, Guru Ram Das, Guru Arjan Dev, Guru Har Gobind Sahib, Guru Har Rai Sahib, Guru Har Krishan Sahib, Guru Tej Bahadur Sahib, and the last one is Guru Gobind Singh Sahib. Guru Nanak also visited Makkah. He realized that the feeling of devotion is common everywhere. He taught that all persons should be treated equally. His teachings aimed at achieving Hindu-Muslim unity. He emphasized chaste behavior. Chaste means innocent and pure behavior. Mainly people were influenced by the teachings of Guru Nanak. The number of his followers increase day by day. The followers of Guru Nanak are known as Sikhs or Shishyas. Shishyas meaning disciples. So the Sikhs are the disciples of Guru Nanak. Guru Granth Sahib, also known as the Adi Granth. The Adi Granth is the scripture of the Sikhs. The Granth was written in Gurumukhi script and it contains the actual words and verses as uttered by the Sikh Gurus. It is considered the supreme spiritual authority and the head of the Sikh religion rather than any living person. It is the holy book of the Sikhs. The Adi Granth includes compositions by Guru Nanak, Sant Namdev, Sant Kabir and other sons. After Guru Gobind Sahib, Sikhs regard Guru Granth Sahib as their Guru as per the orders of Guru Gobind Sahib. We have seen about Guru Nanak and Adi Granth, the holy book of Sikhism. Now we will continue with the principles of Sikhism. The Sikhs believe in one omnipresent, formless God. Sikhs commonly called God Waheguru. Sikhism people regard men and women as equal in all spheres of life. 6. Believe in equality amongst all human beings regardless of race or caste. The freedom to choose and practice religion freely is at the foundation of Sikhism. We believe that there are many paths of God and many avenues to seek truth. Sikhs are expected to perform community service and share with those less fortunate. Observing Sikhs' five articles of faith: Kesh, uncut hair; Kirpan, a ceremonial sword; Kara, an iron bracelet; Kanga, comb; and Kacha, which is breeches. 99% of turban-wearing Americans are Sikhs. The turban expresses a Sikh's commitment to protect and stand up for the values of equality for all people and justice for all people. Sufism may be best described as Islamic mysticism or asceticism. Mysticism means belief that union with or absorption into the deity or the absolute may be attained through contemplation and self-surrender, through which belief and practice helps Muslims attain nearness to Allah by way of direct personal experience of God. The word Sufi is largely believed to stem from the Arabic word Suf, which refers to the wool that was traditionally worn by mystics. You can see in this image the cloth worn by the mystics. It is made up of wool, which means Suf. It is the Arabic word. So it means Suf. Suf means wool. The exact origin of Sufism is disputed. Some sources state that Sufism is the inner dimensions of the teachings of Muhammad, whereas others say that Sufism emerged during the Islamic Golden Age from about the 8th to 10th centuries. However, Islamic scholars predating the Islamic Golden Age were referred to as Sufis like Hassan of Basra. According to Ibn Khaldun, Sufism was already practiced by Sahaba. But with the spread of material tendencies, the term Sufi was just applied to those who emphasized the spiritual practice of Islam. The Sufi saints believe that God is full of love, and the only way to reach Him is through love and devotion. Their main teachings are love for all living beings, meditation, and simple living. Khwaja Muinuddin Chishti. You can see in the first picture, the white turban man is Khwaja Muinuddin Chishti. Sheikh Nizamuddin Awalia. In the second picture, the red turban man is Sheikh Nizamuddin Awalia. They were the great Sufi saints. The teachings of Sufi saints led to the unity in the Hindu-Muslim communities. Sufi music has made valuable contribution to Indian music. You might have heard some songs of Sufi in some movies. In one movie, Jodha Akbar, you might have heard the song Khwaja Mere Khwaja. It is a Sufi song. So Sufi music has made valuable contribution to Indian music. We have seen what is Sufism and who have founded Sufism. Now we are going to understand the salient features of Sufism. Sufism derives its principle from Islam. Although the Sufi saints seek inner purity, but the orthodox Muslims depend upon external conduct and blind observance of religious rituals. Sufism believes that God is the beloved of the lover. Example, the devotee and the devotee is eager to meet his beloved, that is God. Sufism believes that love and devotion are only means of reaching God. Along with Prophet Muhammad, they also attached great importance to their murshid or peer. Sufism believes that devotion is more important than fast, that is roza, or prayer, that is namaz. Sufism discards caste system. Sufism was divided into 12 orders and each under a mystic Sufi saint. So what have we learned from this chapter? We have learned the bhakti movement in different parts of the country by the saints. The path of bhakti taught by the saints was easy to follow for the common people. The bhakti movement was open to all men and women. The saints expressed their thoughts in the language of the people. The common people found them close to their heart. The bhakti movement has contributed greatly to the making of the Indian culture. Mahanubhav Panth, which is about the followers of Krishna, there also we have learnt about the bhakti of Krishna. Then Guru Nanak, about Sikhism, the religion made by Guru Nanak is Sikhism. And the last one is Sufism, about the belief of Islamic people. So now we will move on to the question and answers part of this lesson. Question number 1. Write the related word. Shri Basaveshwar. Where does Shri Basaveshwar reside? He was there in Karnataka. Mirabai. Mirabai was in Mewar. Ramanand was in North India. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Bengal. Shri Chakradhar Swami in Maharashtra. Shankara Deva in Assam. Question number 2. Make a chart to show the people and works related to. So here I have made a chart showing the movements, bhakti movement, Mahanubhav Panth and Sikhism, and the name of the saints who were involved in all these movements and the work that have been done by these saints. So bhakti movement. In bhakti movement, the saints were Sant Mirabai, whose work was that she composed verses on Krishna bhakti. Then Sant Narasimha Mehta, he was the first poet in Gujarati language. Surdas, he wrote a poetical work called Sur Sagar. Then Ras Khan, he composed verses on Krishna Bhakti. Sant Tulsidas, Ramacharita Manas and devotion to Ram. Next is Mahanubhav Panth. The founder of this sect is Chakradhar Swami. Development of the Marathi language, many works were composed in Marathi by Chakradhar Swami. Sikhism. The founder of Sikhism was Guru Nanak. Adi Granth, known as Granth Sahib, Holy Book of Sikhs, composition Sant Namdev and Kabir are included in Adi Granth. Number 3. Complete the following names. Here in the textbook it is given just G and 3 underlined words. You have to find out the letters and the names where it is underlined. So I have given you an example of Guru Gobind Singh. So the G in the beginning and after that 3 letters are underlined, and again G, and again other letters are underlined. So you have to find out the name. Guru Gobind Singh, I found it out. Now, find out the names starting with S, G, M, M, R, K and P. Thank you, students. Now, we will meet in our next session.